ट्रेन रन एट
नो द फॉर्मूला डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू स्पीड इनटू
स्पीड
टाइम.
इनटू टाइम. सो व्हेन वी कन्वर्ट किलोमीटर इनटू मीटर वी गेट 45,000 meters.
तो नहीं, I told you ना 45 किलोमीटर. If you want to convert किलोमीटर पर आवर into मीटर पर सेकंड, multiply that
5 by 18. yes sir.
So if you multiply by 5 by 18, you will get the value called 25 by 2 meter per second. And the time is given as 6 seconds. You know the formula distance.
So 12.5 it will be. So it will be 12.5 into 6.
12.5 into 6.
75 meter.
Yeah, 25 by 2 into 6. So the answer will be 75 meter because options are given in meter. So if the option would have given in kilometer, would have converted 6 seconds into hour. But because the options are given in meter, so we need to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second.
Speed of Aman is ten kilometers. Speed of Rahul is 50 kilometers. When Aman sir, is it 1 PM?
How you did this?
Sir, so speed of Aman is 10 kilometers and speed of Rahul is 15 kilometers. So when Aman reaches 20 kilometers, it'll be 9 AM.
Very good.
So that's when Rahul will start his journey.
Correct.
So after 4 hours, the distance will be 15 into 4, 60, and same 20 plus 10 into 4, which is 60 again.
Very good.
So
very
after
good.
60 kilometer, it will after 4 hours. So 9 plus 14 is 13, and 24 hour clock, 1 o'clock is 13. So
very good, very good. Other way would have solved it by using the concept of relative speed. You know that day I told you. So
here, oh yes, sir.
Aman is going at 15 kilometer per hour, and Aman is going at 10 kilometer per hour, and Rahul at 9 a.m. started at 15 kilometer per hour. If Rahul want to catch Aman, then the speed of Rahul should be more than the speed of Aman. Otherwise, Rahul can never catch Aman. So
yes, now,
if you see the relative distance between them is 20 kilometer, and if you see the relative speed between them is 5 kilometer per hour. Every hour, Rahul will run 15 kilometer, but Rahul is thinking that Aman will be waiting there, but Aman will not wait here. Aman will another run 10 kilometer. So you can understand actually every hour, if you calculate the distance, how the distance is actually decreasing between them. So it decreases by 5 kilometer per hour. So if the relative distance between them is 20 kilometer, if the relative speed between them is 5 kilometer per hour, how much time for them to meet? That would be 4 hours. So after 4 hours means 1 p.m. after 9 a.m. After 4 hours, Rahul will cover total 60 kilometers, and there would be the Aman. Aman is running at 10 kilometers per hour. So Aman is running at 10 kilometers per hour. Aman has actually walked for 8 kilometers. Sorry, Aman has actually walked for 8 hours. So
yes,
8 into 10, it would be 80 kilometers. So total Aman has walked 80 kilometers. Rahul has walked 60 kilometer, and finally at 1 p.m. Rahul will catch him. Third question.
Yes, sir. Sir, 350 meter.
Very good, very good. So always remember, normally when we solve these kind of questions, so we include or we consider the length of a train. If the train length is given, we include the length. If the length of a platform is given, we will talk about the length. If the length of maybe bridge is given, we include the length, but we do not will not consider the length of a person or the length of electric pole and all. So here in this problem, it is given a train which is 150 meter long, it running at 60 kilometer per hour. So 60
kilometer. Sir, I converted it into meter because the answers were in meters.
Yeah, yeah. So that is the way.
16.67 meter.
Means 1/6. 16.67, so 60 into 5/18.
5/18.
This is 10/3. So 50/3. So this would be 20. So 16.67, 50/3 only. So
yes,
so this is 50/.
So 150 plus length is equal to 16.
So when the train is crossing the bridge, the train has to cover its own length, which is 150 meter, plus the length of the bridge. That
Which is equal to
16.67 or 50 by
into 30.
Into 30. So this would be 500.
Yes, sir.
150 plus B is equal to 500. So the length of bridge would be 350.
350, yes, sir.
Okay. Total distance it covered 150.
So 1 hour.
Nahi beta, total see 3 hour is the time and the speed is 50 kilometer per hour. So what is the total distance it covered? 150 kilometer, correct?
Yes, sir.
And if it going at the speed which is 75 kilometer per hour, so how much time will you take? 2 hours.
Okay, yes, sir. So 5 seconds.
5 seconds. I don't know the answer. 1 minute. The train which is 120 meter long crosses a pole in 10 seconds. In the speed,
so speed will be distance by time.
The length of pole is 120.
Speed is 12 meter per second.
How much time will take a train of 180 meter long coming in opposite direction? So the length of another train is 120 plus 80 meters. 200 meter.
200 meter, yes, sir.
So that is
so 200 by 14, no, sir.
L1 plus L2 will be 200 meter.
200 by 40, 12 yes. Plus 28.
Yeah, so.
So 5 seconds.
Yeah, so 440. Yeah. So you can remember one thing here, that always remember if there's a one train of length L1, speed S1, there's another train of length L2, speed S2. If they're coming in opposite direction, okay, so the time for them to cross each other will be L1 plus L2 divided by S1 plus S2. Okay, you know the
concept. Okay, sir.
It is speed. And imagine if the two trains go in same direction. So this is L1, this is S1, this is L2, this is S2. This is going in this direction. Both are going same direction. Now the second train, the train B, if the train B want to cross train A, then S1 should be greater than S2. Correct?
Yes, sir.
B can cross it. Then time for them to cross each other will be L1 plus L2.
L2 by
S1 minus S2.
Minus S2. Okay, sir.
Length is always added. The total distance is always the length of the two trees.
Oh, sir, 60 kilometer per hour.
So, sir, Tabdi Express covers certain distance in 50 minutes. 50 minutes.
So, 50 by 60.
So this is how
much? 5/6.
40 kilometer.
It will. Yes, sir. So 4/6. Yes, sir.
So the if we want to cover.
So distance will be.
40.
40 kilometer.
By 40 by.
For 40 minutes. So. Yes, sir. So distance will be equal to 48 into 50 by 60 is equal to X. You can take it as X into 40 by 60. So when you solve that, you get V is equal to 60.
Otherwise, you get here 40 kilometer, no? So
yes, sir. You can cut. Yes, sir. So you can just cut 40. 40
kilometer divided by 40 minutes.
40. Yes, sir.
So 1 kilometer per minute. 60 kilometer per hour. Now here you cannot use that formula. The formula of average speed, that 2ab by a plus b, you cannot use it here. In the previous classes, I told you the formula of average speed as 2ab by a plus b. That formula you can only use when the distance is same. So if you are covering the same distance in both the case, then only you can use this formula. Otherwise, if the distance are different, then you use the formula of average speed as the total distance covered by total time taken.
Okay, sir. Sir, 46 2 by 3 kilometer per hour.
So 60 kilometer at 40 kilometer per hour.
Sir, it will be 3 by 2 hours. T2 will be 40 by 60, which is 2 by 3 hours.
That would be 2 by 3 hours.
Yes, sir. So the average speed will be 60 plus 40 divided by 3 by 2 plus 2 by
3. 13 by 6 hour total time. Total distance is 100 kilometers.
Yes, sir.
Average speed is total distance by total time.
So 100 by 13 by 6, yes, sir.
100 by 13. 13 fours are 52, 13 sixes are
7. 6 are 70, yes, sir. Sir, 48 minutes.
Imagine if I would have asked you, walking at 4 by 3 of a usual speed, a man is 16 minutes early, then how much would be your, what would be your answer? You understood this, Gani?
Yes, sir. That's my
shortcut, if you remember, I told you that like here you know that distance is equal to speed into time. Distance is equal to speed into time. So understanding both the case, you are covering the same distance. Here the distance is constant. Here your distance is constant. So if your distance is constant, then here it means speed is inversely proportional to time. Because the speed is inversely proportional to time, remember 1 by x increase in speed will be 1 by x plus 1 decrease in time, and 1 by x decrease in speed will be 1 by x minus 1 increase in time. So you can remember, so if I'm walking at 3 by 4th of my usual speed, if I'm walking at 3 by 4th of my usual speed, means 3 by 4 means 75%?
Yes, sir.
75% means because of certain reasons, you are not moving at your normal speed. You are moving at 75% of your speed. So if your speed was x, now your speed is 3 by 4x. Means how much your speed decreased? Your speed has decreased by 1 by 4. Earlier it was x, now you are moving at 3 by 4x. So if your speed decreased by 1 by 4, then your time will increase by 1 by 3. You can understand this. If your speed will decrease by 1 by 4, your time will increase by 1 by 3. So the time which is increased by 1 by 3, that is equal to how much? That is given to you 60 minutes. What is the usual time for you to reach office? That would be 48 minutes. Other way, if I say that if I ask you, you're walking at 4 by 3 of usual speed. If you walk at 4 by 3 of usual speed, so now you are walking at 4 by 3 of your speed. So earlier your speed was x, now your speed is 4 by 3x. So if your speed is 4 by 3x, so how much your speed has actually increased? 1 by 3?
Yes, sir.
So means your speed has increased by 1 by 3. So if your speed will increase by 1 by 3, automatically your time will decrease. So your time will decrease by 1 by 4. And how much your time has decreased? That is 16 minutes. So how much was the usual time? That was 64 minutes.
No, just between
So 20 kilometers.
20 kilometers. It is given that the time what the E takes.
So x by 8.
That is 1 by 2 means 30 minutes.
Yes, sir. So x by 8 and time taken by B will be x by 10.
X plus 1 by 2. You just solve it. The LCM.
Yes, sir. 40. Yes, sir.
X is equal to 2.
Yes, sir. So 2x will be 40. X will be 20.
See this. So there's a person sitting on a train, which is slower train, and this train is going at 20 km per hour. Okay, and there's a train which is faster train that is going at 40 km per hour. Okay, Dhwani.
Faster 200 meter.
Not sure about the answer. So one thing I want in this problem, what we need to understand here, while considering the length, the total distance, d value, like in this chapter, no, we use a formula d is equal to s into t. So
yes, sir.
Here in the d is not dependent on the length of the train in which the person is sitting. I hope you understand me. So it doesn't.
Yes, sir. So it will be the relative velocity of first train with respect to the second train, right?
Yeah, so that is
20. So 40 minus 20, which is 20
kilometer per hour, that you convert
converted into meter per second, so that will be 5.5 bars.
Yeah, that would be 5 by 18, so you can write this is equal to 200 meters. So the only concept we need to understand, so it doesn't matter where you're sitting in this train. Okay, so you can be sitting anywhere in the train. Now, when you're seeing another train crossing this train, so it only here the total time what the train, what I took to saw the complete train is independent of the train in which I'm sitting. I may be running also. Maybe I'm running at 20 kilometer per hour and there's another train which crossed me which was running at 40 kilometer per hour. So it doesn't matter at all. So here the length of the another train is insignificant. So the length of the faster train is 200 meters. So, Dhoni, did you understand this concept?
Yes, sir. We took x as the, yes, sir.
I took x, suppose.
Yes, sir, I understood.
Earlier speed was x. So, now, only thing though, while solving this problem, what we need to worry about to set the equation properly. So, if you go faster, you will take less time. So, 10 minutes, where will you add? Where will you subtract? All that we need to spend time. I'll very quickly, very soon, I'll take one class on quadratic equation for you. So that you, in any time, whenever, because quadratic equation, linear equation, numbers, more or less, every chapter we need here and there to solve the problem. You could have solved this problem by simply inserting these values into this. So no need of solving all this. No need of solving all this. We could have easily inserted these options. If you would have inserted these options in the equation, you would have get the answer very easily. When the option is there, you can, whenever you see there's a possibility of quadratic equation, avoid solving it. Always insert options to get the answer. That would be the fastest way to get the answer. Like, I'll give you an example. So, like this, question number 17, if you see. If you see this problem. So, this is actually a quadratic equation. And whenever you are solving any problem of any chapter, and you see that by any chance, there's a possibility that quadratic equation will be formed, always the option is the best option. First, I'll show you without using option, how the scenario can be complicated, and with option, how the scenario can be very easy. So a journey of 192 kilometer takes 2 hours less by a fast train than by a slow train. So there's a fast train is there. There's a fast train, and then you have a slow train. You have fast train, and then you have a slow train. And if you consider the speed, so let the speed of fast train is x. Let the speed of what they ask you, speed of fast train. No? Let the speed of fast train is x. Whatever they have asked you, you should take that as x. Then a journey when you take 2 hours less by a fast train. Okay, if the average speed of slow train is 16 kilometer less, so the speed of slow train would be x minus 16 kilometer per hour. They are covering the distance as 192 kilometer and 2 hours less by fast train. So if you see that time, if you see the factor of time, if this take y hour, so it will take y plus 2 hours. So fast train take 2 hours less. So then the distance what they're covering, so this is xy is equal to 192 kilometer. Here x minus 16 into y plus 2 is equal to 192 kilometer. Now we can spend time solving this. If this kind of question comes in school, then you have no option. You have to solve this step by step only. But if, imagine you're writing NTSC exam. Next year you will write NTSC exam, 10th standard. So such kind of exam when you write, you simply insert and you get the answer. I can write this as xy plus 2x. So xy plus 2x minus 16y minus 32 is equal to 192. So x in place of xy, I can put 192. So 192 will get cancelled. So I can write 2x minus 16y minus 32 is equal to 0. So I can write x minus 8y minus 16 is equal to 0. So now x and y relation, xy is 192. So y is equal to 192 by x. So if I insert it here, x minus 8 into 192 by x is equal to 16. So if you take LCM x square minus 192, 8 is 16, 72, 73, 1536 is equal to 16x. So x square minus 16x minus 1536 is equal to 0. Now solving this would be a bit cumbersome task. So we need to find the factors of 1536. Pooja, this is 70, how much? 768. Then Pooja, this would be 3384. Then Pooja, 192. So then Pooja, then 96. Then Pooja, then 58. Then Pooja, 24. Then 24. 12, then 6, then 13. So 1536, if you see, it becomes such a big now. Now you can see solving would be big task here. So 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2 to the power 9 into 3. 2 to the power 9 into 3. Close figure, if I take 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12. Well, then also not 12 to the 24. So how much I took the factor? 3, 8. If I took 8, so if I take 24 to the 48, if I take 48, so 48 means how much I've taken? 4 power of 2 I've taken. So 5 power of 2 would be 32. 48 minus 32 is 16. So luckily I got, so x square minus 48x plus 32x minus 1536 is equal to 0. So now this, if I take this common, this is x minus 48, this is plus 32 common, x minus 32. Now in 32 table, will you get 1536? 32 5za is 116. So 4za it will go, 32 4za is what, 128. So definitely should be 48 one day. That is a possibility. So this is 0. So you can write x plus 32 x minus 48. That will be 0. So you get x value equal to 48 and 32. So the x value would be 48 only. You understood this, right? Now, other way, if you get, if you suppose you stuck in such kind of equation, x square minus 16x minus 1536 is equal to 0. If you are not lucky enough to figure out this 48 and 32, then you are most welcome to use that formula, alpha beta root formula, minus b plus minus, remember this formula, under root of,
yes sir,
minus 4ac by 2a. So what is a here? A is equal to 1. What is b here? Minus 16. What is c here? Minus 1536. Correct, na? So alpha beta, so minus b, 16 plus minus 16 square, 256, minus minus plus, minus, this c minus. So you get 4ac, means 1536 rosa. So this is 24, 14, 21, 21, 2, 6, 1, 4, 4, 6, 1, 4, 4, by 2a. So 6, 1, 4, 4, 6, 1, 4, 4. Plus 256, this is 10, 10, 6400, under root of 6400, yeah, lucky we get easy numbers, under root of 6400 is 80 by 2, so 96 by 2, or negative number, there's no point, this is 48. So with so much effort, we got the answer 48. The same thing we would have got very easily if you would have inserted options. Like imagine, go by option wise, no need to solve it. Suppose your first option is 12. If what they ask you, what is the speed of fast train? And that I have taken x. That is what I have to find. No, I have to find x.
Yes, sir.
So if I take x equal to 12, then x minus 16 would be negative. Speed cannot be.
Yes, sir. So it can't be.
So 16, if I put, then this will be
0.
So then also not possible. 32, if I put
16.
32. So if this is 32.
16.
So this would be 16. Now,
yes,
now 16, 192. This would be, then this would be 1. This would be 12.
Yes, sir.
X plus 2, then it would be 12. So if x plus 2 is 12, means then x would be equal to 10.
Sorry, yes, sir. Correct.
Y would be equal to 10. So this 32 into 10, then it would be 320. But here this is 192.
92, yes, sir.
Again, this cannot be the option. So only option left would be
48. Yes.
So whenever you solve the problem, now you are 9, you will be 10. So gradually the level of problems when you solve chapters of linear equation or any other algebra based chapter or arithmetic chapter based chapter, if anywhere it require for you to use the concept of quadratic equation, it would be always be good if options are available, use options instead of solving the problem and all, and imagine how much the time we end up in spending to get the answer. In exam, in school exam, we have no option, we have to solve only. But in imagine nowadays, objective type questions also you get in exam portions, or you get any exam where there's a possibility that you can use option, always use options whenever you're seeing the possibility of quadratic equation. So we'll do this much today. We'll continue tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, see you tomorrow.